Welcome to War India News Hour. Your own smartphone can be used as a weapon against you. Pegasus, created by NSO of Israel, goes down as the deadliest tool made for compromising smartphones. NSO is best known for marketing Pegasus. This is a highly invasive tool which is set to switch on target's cell phone camera and microphone and access its data. In real terms, the phone is turned into a pocket spy. Pegasus is well recognized as the pocket spy. What it could mean to the future of democracy need not be debated. The usage of this tool is to go through the Israeli government route. Facebook, in October, owner of WhatsApp, filed a suit against NSO in US, leveling charges that this company has been using this popular messaging service as a platform to conduct cyber espionage. It claims this sort of espionage was conducted on nearly 1,400 journalists, diplomats, and human rights activists worldwide. It's been used as a political tool, is the claim. Senior officials of over 20 countries allied with the US have reportedly been the targets of the hacking campaign. NSO, on the other hand, has requested the court to sanction Facebook for $17,000 as legal fees. It challenges the basic premise of the lawsuit, stating that it only provides software to governments with the only purpose of fighting terrorism and crime. A subject matter expert says this seems to be the replay of the FBI and Apple case, though this time both the parties to the case are private business entities. In the interplay of these two legendary companies comes the roles of governments and how data or fact or official work and approval is devised and taken through. Hence, the capability of being able to get, use and manipulate data by hook or by crook is turning out to be the winning combination. The legal battle will always be an afterthought. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Sports and online fantasy sports become integral to future of sports in India. Today, the online fantasy sports, that is OFS, has become an integral major sporting event in India. It has in fact catapulted many sports fans and enthusiasts to utilize their understanding of the game and player performances and even enhance them as they engage with more sports and leagues. Today, technology through online fantasy sports has brought all of these into reality, wherein fans can now have a scientific way of engaging with the game in a platform that truly helps them evaluate and know more besides demonstrating their capabilities, which was till now confined to discussions at homes, street corners, offices and social gatherings. YouTube buys a young Indian startup, SimSim. Google's video platform YouTube has signed a definitive agreement to acquire social commerce SimSim, a Gurgaon-headquartered startup. It helps small businesses in India transition to e-commerce by using the power of video and creators. The startup's eponymous app acts as a platform to connect local businesses, influencers, and customers. The expected value is more than $70 million. Two-year-old SimSim had raised about $17 million prior to today's announcement and was valued at $50.1 million in its 2020 Series B financing round. Fortinet fixes bug on unauthenticated hackers run code as root. Fortinet has released updates for its FortiManager and FortiAnalyzer network management solutions to fix a serious vulnerability that could be exploited to execute arbitrary code with the highest privileges. Both FortiManager and FortiAnalyzer are enterprise-grade network management solutions for environments with up to 1 lakh devices. They are available as a physical appliance, as a virtual machine in the cloud, or hosted by Fortinet. Pegasus become a global headache, targets thousands of people around the world. Pegasus is a spying software developed by Israel's NSO. Reports claim that phones of over 40 Indian journalists were hacked. The chairperson of the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Information Technology, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, has demanded an independent probe into the matter. It is becoming clear that perhaps there is a need for an independent inquiry headed by a Supreme Court judge who would have the power not just to summon witnesses but also to weigh the evidence in a judicial manner. Dr. Tharoor said, "It is a matter of concern because obviously in our country, we are a democracy, there is freedom of expression. You don't expect the government to be interfering with journalists doing their duty." Senior leaders were accusing the government of defending Pegasus spyware issue instead of probing this serious cause. Hackers exploit 16-year-old security bug impacts millions of HP, Samsung, Xerox printers. A 16-year-old security vulnerability affecting millions of HP, Samsung, Xerox printer drivers allows hackers to gain admin rights on systems using the vulnerable driver software. As per the researchers, some HP, Xerox and Samsung printers models contained vulnerable driver software sold worldwide since 2005. Hundreds of millions of printers have been released worldwide to date with the vulnerable driver in question. The buggy driver automatically gets installed with the printer software and will be loaded by Windows after each system reboot. This makes the driver a perfect candidate to target since it will always be loaded on the machine even if there is no printer connected, the researchers said. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Stay tuned. Thank you.